Hello and welcome to this mod review. So today we're looking at two Zetor tractors and two Renault tractors. We've got the Zetor 7745 here, which I'll get to in a second. The Zetor 16145, Renault Atles 925 and 936RZs. So we're going to start with the little Zetor. Now, straight away we can see the textures are slightly off on here, at least on the bonnet. Sort of material textures do not look quite how they should do, but all in all, this looks a nice little tractor if you ignore those few features of it. Let's just hop inside. So, nice clear dials, what kind of energy drink stuffed in the side there. You keep that stuff. So start the tractor up, and this is where some of the first of the new sounds come in on here. So got the working dial there. Limited movement on the steering wheel. Nice sort of textures on the exhaust there with heat and rust, etc. Brakes work well on it. Lighting wise, beacon all works. We have no working indicators on here. Front lights, rear work light, top work lights come on. No lights on the dashboard. I've got a small plough over there we can just try backing that up onto to see what happens. I know it's a bit bigger than you'd actually use on this tractor. There's a few of these in this area in real life. That's why I look at it. So we have hitching noises. So I would say that the weights could be slightly off on the tractor. There's no front weight on the front of this. Not that I can see anyway. We will just put it in the ground up here. As far as I think from memory, this tractor is a lot smaller than it's supposed to be used on this plough. So I'd say that's about accurate for what I'd expect putting that in the ground there. But it does at least stay in the ground and do as it should do. So that's one good thing. There's not really too much more inside to this. Lacks refinement, I think, would be the best description of it. I might want that again in a second. Nice little tractor nonetheless. Everything looks up as it should do. Could do a few little tweaks here and there. Cam all works as it should do on there. So some interesting sounds to it. So let's get onto its bigger sibling here. 16145. And we start this one up. Going cab. Dials work, steering wheel moves as it should do. Brake and accelerator pedals function. Come outside. We have left indicators front and back. Right indicators front and back, rear lights, lots of front light, rear work lights, front work lights, stroke main beam. It's all good on the lighting side of things here. Okay, no lights on the dashboard. custom sounds with this one again. Textures don't look too bad on this one either. So we'll put this one on that 4-furrow plough again. We'll limit movement on the steering wheel for the AI in there. Got all the hitching sounds on there. So I'll just go up and down the field with the plough and see what it does. Gradual build up the power there. Nice sounding tractor. Just something a bit different from the normal, this one. Brakes are shocking on this, to say the least, and from what I know of Zetors, it could be fairly accurate in that respect. Here's the brake lights function. Older tractors. This is quite a nice one. Working seat suspension. You can see there. A lot more refined than the other little seat we just had a look at. A bit resemblable with the other one there. See how long it takes to slow down. Let me just hop out. See, the textures look a lot better on this one. Material textures and everything. You compare that to the textures on this one. Whilst the lights look quite good in the front, everything else is just a little bit off. So that takes us to these big ones over here. So we got these two Renault Atles tractors. Textures not too bad on them. Some nice options there. Put the twin wheels on this one. There's no other difference between these two tractors other than the wheels. And wheel weights on this one. So get in, got realistic looking seat material. A few plot markers lying down there. Dashboard all lights up. Accelerator pedal works, brake pedals work. Come outside, we've got a rear view camera at the top there. So we've actually got three cameras on this tractor. Got one at the top there. It's a nice little addition really, that one, as we've seen the trailers. Brakes function on it. Left indicator. Right indicator. Rear lights, front lights, rear work lights, front work lights. They all function. Let's get this one on the plough over here. We know this one's big enough to take the blow. Hitching sounds, front links all functions as it should do. Not too keen on the hub in the middle of the rear wheels, that's not very accurate. Kind of spools it a bit, but that could soon be rectified, I'm sure. There's not a lot of ground clearance on the rear hitch on there. Not I'll try it up the field and see what it does. I'd say the rear hitch geometry could do with a little tweak on there for how high it lifts. This player's already touching the ground. It's a little bit of an issue with the hitch there, unfortunately. Power wise, no problem. Hitch all works, it should do. Got some seat suspension there. Put this back down the other end, then we'll have a look in the shop at these tractors. Starting to run out of land to plough on this field now. See, it's hitting the ground as we turn at the ends. It's a bit unfortunate. I was actually using this map to play with the GPS the other night, hence why some of this field is now drilled. There's no difference internally between these two Atlas tractors. Quite a big tractor to drive in real life. I have had a few hours on one in the past, with orange and green and white. Nice looking tractors anyway, just shame about that hitch issue. It's not insurmountable though. So let's have a look in the shop now. So the Zetors, the 7754, absolutely no options whatsoever with that tractor. 77 horsepower, £39,000. It does have front weights under there. So that's it for that tractor. Nothing more you'd say about that one. Medium tractors. Zeta Crystal. That also comes with this ZTS one. It's exactly the same. That's why I haven't actually done anything with it. So what we've got here. Without front fenders, with front fenders. No price option. Standard wheels, wheel weights. Wide tyres, standard. But here's the best bit, it's £9,000. So if we want a cheap tractor any time, it's 160 horsepower. Yes, it's only 32k forward speed, but Zetas were always known to be a bit slow on the road, especially these older ones. And I think GPS would be pushing our luck with a Zeta somehow of this age. It looks from the picture as if it's got open the roof hatch, so we'll have another look at that in a moment. Now the Atlases for some reason are in this series. So the 925, 226 horsepower, wheel options standard, with weights, wide tyres and weights, rear twin, narrow. Rear twin narrows, all round twin narrows, back to standard. 936, 250 horsepower, exactly the same wheel options, 133,000. They're not bad tractors for the money. So let's just have another look at this Zetor over here. We better put the HUDs back on so we can just see if there is anything in here. So it seems we have some OC on this one. So we could add a new element here. So K and M. So we've got opening and closing door there. And on that side. That's a nice little addition to it. So, even if you don't press shift, it still opens and closes the door. Let's try again. So, left shift J, roof hatch. I was pressing right shift before accidentally. So, back window opens and closes, roof hatch opens and closes, and both doors open and close on the Zeta. So that's a nice little feature to that one. Let's just double check this one as well. So it looks as if our little one may suddenly, this little Zeta's got a little bit more going for it. We have opening closing doors. Opening and closing bonnet. Interesting feature. And opening and closing rear window on there. Except it goes round too far on the inside. Might get a headache with that one. So this is coming with something as well. So left control K. If we can see that very well. But left control K and M, open and close the side window. Left shift, left control, K and M is back window. And J and N is the door. So all three of these tractors actually come with some IC on them. So nice little touch there. So, three different tractors there, differing in qualities, but all with IC on, even the most basic one of them. So, nice features there. So that's where we'll leave this mod review, and I'll say thank you for watching, hope you found this useful. If you have, please remember to drop me a like and subscribe if you haven't done already. And I will see you next time. Goodbye for now.